In the last video, we discussed the critical challenges facing agriculture and the food system, and how regenerative agriculture can help address those challenges. In this video, we'll talk about what regenerative ag is and how it works. Regenerative ag can be described a lot of different ways. While there are a lot of definitions, and I'll share General Mills' definition at the end of the video, one thing that most agree on is that regenerative ag is a set of principles. These are principles that can be applied by any farmer anywhere to regenerate their agricultural ecosystem, leading to benefits like improved soil health, enhanced nutrient cycling, carbon sequestration, and resilience to extreme weather. The first principle is to understand context. No two farms or farmers are the same. What works for a farmer in Minnesota might not work for another farmer down the road, let alone one in California. The key to success is understanding the context of a given field, its soils and climate, its constraints and opportunities, and then to develop a plan to integrate the other principles based on that context. The next principle is to minimize disturbance. Disturbances like tillage, where plows or discs are used to disrupt the soil, or overapplying fertilizers and pesticides, can disrupt the agricultural ecosystem. Minimizing these chronic disturbances is an important first step to letting the soil and ecosystem recover. The next principle is to maximize crop diversity. Maximizing diversity is a way that farmers can naturally defend themselves against pests, weeds, and diseases, and growing a diversity of plants helps to feed the soil a diverse diet, which improves soil health. Next is to keep the soil covered. There are forces like wind and rain constantly trying to erode soil and take it off the field, and hot sun can bake bare soil, evaporating out the moisture and killing the life below ground. Keeping the soil covered prevents erosion, retains moisture, and keeps the soil cool. The next principle is keep a living root in the ground year-round or as long as possible throughout the year. This is important because soil is a living thing, and like all living things, it needs food in order to survive. The food that the soil eats is carbon, that plants pull out of the air through photosynthesis and pump below ground. If you think about most of the crops that farmers grow, whether it's corn, soybeans, oats, or wheat, they only grow for a few months out of the year. For a lot of the year, there's nothing growing to feed the soil. By making sure there's always something growing in the field, regenerative farmers are keeping the soil fed and pulling carbon out of the atmosphere, where it contributes to climate change. The last principle is integrate livestock. By integrating livestock into cropland and managing them in dense herds with frequent moves, farmers can more quickly regenerate their farm ecosystem. Livestock can eat things people can't, so it makes it easier for farmers to economically grow a greater diversity of plants. And the animal impact through trampling, dung, and urine can speed up nutrient cycling and improve soil health. When implemented together in a system, these principles enable farmers to regenerate their soil and the rest of the farm ecosystem. Now for a little pop quiz on the principles. This is an example of what I see in a lot of the fields around where I live in Minnesota, and maybe around where you live too, from about October to May. Thinking about the principles, what do you see? What's missing? I see a lot of disturbance. This clumpy soil is a sign that the field has been tilled. I see a lot of bare soil. There's nothing covering the soil surface, so it's completely exposed to wind and rain. There are no living plants, so there's no food for the soil, and obviously there's no diversity or livestock. So none of the principles are here, and this is what a lot of the fields look like for a lot of the year. Is this field organic or conventional? There's no way to tell. The regenerative principles can be applied by any farmer, organic or conventional, to improve their soil. Is it regenerative? Because none of the principles are present, this soil is likely degrading, not regenerating. This is a picture of what a field in this part of the world could look like. Even in North Dakota in November, this farmer is growing a green mix of plants called a cover crop, which is a crop that the farmer doesn't intend to harvest. Its purpose is just to keep the soil fed and keep it covered, which improves soil health and pulls carbon out of the atmosphere. When the principles are combined together in a regenerative system, it works to repair and enhance natural ecosystem processes, like the water cycle, pictured here. This field on the left isn't able to absorb the rain that's falling because it has no structure, so the water washes away and carries precious soil into streams and rivers. This field on the right has been feeding the soil and keeping it covered, which has restored the soil structure and the water cycle. The soil can absorb all of the rain and use it to grow plants. While this is a picture of the water cycle, regenerative systems also work to fix the nutrient cycle, the carbon and energy cycle, the pest and disease cycle, these various processes that play out on farms that ultimately determine a farmer's success. General Mills defines regenerative ag as a holistic, principles-based approach to farming and ranching that seeks to strengthen ecosystems and community resilience. We take an outcomes-based definition, as opposed to one based on practices, that seeks improvements in soil health, biodiversity, water, and farmer economic resilience. In order to accelerate this farmer-led movement, we've made a commitment to advance regenerative ag on 1 million acres by 2030. In the next video, I'll talk about some of the issues farmers face in implementing regenerative ag and the specific initiatives we've launched to help them overcome those barriers.